14 verse 1.
It's a judgment.
Then I look and behold, on Mount Zion stood the Lamb, and with him 144,000, who had his name and his father's name written in their foreheads. 144,000 of elect men.
144,000 Yahusha's weapons.
144,000 of truly blessed men.
His men and virgins, not the foul but women.
When that final trumpet sounds, that is the third woe. Judges would be slaves, also the Pope. For pedophilia, he swings on the rope. Two-thirds would perish, broke Deuteronomy coast. White Jesus can't save us, says it is exposed. Swords dipped in blood, reapers kicking in your doors. You eat a mite, wife gets a lice turned out. Mighty men of Yahuwah, run up in your house. Ottoman Turks beheaded, not a soul will flee. Judgment for what you did in 1453. Constantinople, Edomites have no hope, bro. Wives getting ravaged, husbands like, oh no. Santa's really Satan, pimp you like a hoe. Just scrambled the letters, angel making it to heaven with your sons and daughters. Worshipping the devil, cool Santa Claus, I bet.
Yom Tov. Ani Kahan Tazadak, and I want to give you this message through the Tanakh and the Basura, through the Holy Spirit of the Ruach HaKadosh, Heavenly Baba Yah. So we're going to talk about today the 144,000, whether or not these was all men, and whether these men were virgins, or as the good brother Jaidir says, eunuchs. So I want to say these were all men, but unfortunately today there's been a lot of infiltration into the Word of the Most High. A lot of feminists has actually moved in, and so men are catering to women. And this is in particular what this scripture is actually referring to when it says they have not been defiled by women. It means that they have not taken on a feminist ideology. So let's read the scripture and let's get into this. And I pray that you get the understanding from this when you leave this particular video. Go and research everything that I'm saying here. So Revelations Apocalypse 14 verse 4. These are those who are not defiled by women, for they are virgins. These are the ones who follow the Lamb wherever he goes. These were redeemed from among men, being first fruit to Yahuwah, to the Lamb. Revelations 14 and 4. So this is obviously all men, but also men that haven't been defiled by women. Now this doesn't mean that these men are eunuchs, Jaidir. It doesn't mean that these men haven't had sex. These men are spiritual virgins, meaning that their minds have not been defiled by feminist ideology or female influence, as are many of the churches and synagogues today. You see female rabbis, which you can't find in scriptures, right? You see women preachers, right? So men are catering and they're defiled by women ideology. Because they saying, well, everything's supposed to be 50-50. I'm not a male chauvinist. I'm just a true adept of Yahuwah Alachayim. And so if you don't want the truth, don't listen to me. See, Adonai cannot use men that's actually been defiled by female influence. This is not talking about sex, right? So let me deal with the first part first, right? To show that they are all men, right? And feminists will not like this. They will label me a misogynist. Well, take a number and get online, because I'm going to tell the truth. Book of Ezekiel 34 and 31. Ezekiel 34 and 31. And ye, my flock, the flock of my pasture, are men. And I am your Elohim, Sev Adonai, Yahuwah. Yahuwah. So now, let me make something else perfectly clear. In the last book of the Tanakh, Book of Malachi, Yahuwah tells us what must be done for the earth to be fixed. To fix the problems on the earth, he said that there's one important thing, and he says that's in Malachi 4, verse 5 and 6. Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming and the great dreadful day of Adonai. Verse 6. And he shall turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, and the hearts of the children to the fathers. Least, meaning else, I come and I smite the earth with a curse. So he said the way to fix the earth's problems is to turn the hearts of the children to the fathers and the fathers to the children, not to the mothers. What does society say? Give the child to the mother in the event of a divorce. That's not what Yahuwah said. We're going to teach the truth and we're going to teach hard. Now, if you don't want the truth, don't listen to me. Now, for 400 years after that, there's a period of silence. There was no prophets, there was no messengers, there was no priest teaching. 400 years later, this prophecy is fulfilled because Yahusha HaMashiach comes on the scene and he chooses 12 men, also representing the 12 tribes of Israel, to what? To fix the earth's problems, to give them a message to go and teach the entire earth. So the Bible indicates, now, one more thing, that Jacob had one daughter, Dinah. We can read that in Bereshit, Genesis 30 and 19 through 21, Genesis 34, 1 through 3, and Genesis 46 and 15. You could go and read it for yourself. I'm not going to read ahead. Now, Christian ideology, again, is seeping into the Bible. Now, where I recommend you to be able to understand some Hebrew, it's not required for you to read it because a modern Ibrit was influenced by a man by the name of Elazar ben Yehuda. This guy. He utterly has mixed in Latin, Greek, and English into the Ibrit. So the modern Hebrew, I want to make this abundantly clear, though you hear me speaking it, it is not the authentic Hebrew. It is not like the Paleo Ibrit. The Paleo Hebrew did not have any vowels. The Masoretic text, the Masoretes, they came in, they stopped people from pronouncing the name of Yahuah, Yahawah, Elohim, or Elohim. See, and this is what I want to say. See, Elohim, which is their holy tongue, the Kadash tongue, with the Masoretes, when they added their Nakud, which is their vowels, it became Elohim. You understand? So they changed the pronunciation of many words by doing that. And so people pronounce things differently. So they have something known as a vet, which is really supposed to be ba, a bet. So they added the nachud and they have this vet. So some of their words is pronounced with a V enunciation when you listen to it in the English. So this is why I'm saying be very careful of the Hebrew, because when you read many of their writings also, you will see that they've changed a lot of words around. The only way that you're really going to get the real truth is if you have the Holy Ruach on you. And if you have the Holy Ruach on you, you're not going to lie. You're not going to try and change the text and say, oh, well, a woman could be a Kohen also. The scriptures doesn't say that. You understand? And it's not for you to say, well, I'm a Kohen under the high priest's order of Melchizedek. It's HaMashiach and Mashiach. But let me get back to this. So Jacob, even though he had 13 children, a lot of people will want you to believe that Jacob had daughters because they read English translations that don't really indicate the Hebrewic meaning, right? For instance, like Genesis 37, Bereshit 37, verse 34 and 35. And so we read in that, in 34, so Jacob tore his clothes and put on sackcloth, undergarment, over his waist, and mourned for his sons and many days. Then all his sons and his daughters got up to confront him, but he refused to be confronted. All right, so it used the word daughters there in the English translation. Let me show you something in the Ibri. All right, watch this. The word for daughter in the Ibri is bath. Bath. English translation would be daughter. You see that? It has the bet and the hay, right? Bath. Right? Now, when we look at the word for daughters, because they mistranslated this again also in Genesis 46, 5 through 7. See, when we read the seven verses, it says his sons and his grandsons and his daughters. So again, it's using the word bat, which is singular. It's not plural. So the plural, if that was to be plural, it would have had the nun in it. Bat north. back north, it would have had the noon. You see what I'm saying? See, that's the plural of daughters. And so this is why sometimes you need to look it up in the Ibrit. But again, do not trust this modern Ibrit. This is 8th century Hebrew that they changed when we came out of the Assyrian captivity. They came out with the Babylonian block script. You understand? So it no longer looks like the Paleo, and it no longer sounds like the Paleo, because again, the Mesorites added the Nakhud, and it changes a lot of the pronunciation. And when I read a lot of these things in their writings, they've tried to alter intentionally a lot of the meanings of the word of Yahuwah, Elohim. So I just wanted to put that out there so you could go and read that on your own. Now, the other thing I want you to remember is that we need to deal with the other half of that scripture, right? Where it says, be fruitful and multiply. So the Most High is not going to cut himself, right? So the first half, we see he's dealing with men. The flock of his pasture is men. And so when we deal with that, but we see in there that the word, well, we look it up in the Ibrit, we deal with the men part, right? Ezekiel 34:3. He says, ye, my flock, the flock of my pastor are Adam, and I am your Elohim, says Adonai Yahuwah or Yahawah. So he's saying the flock of his pastor is men. That is definitely a masculine trait, Adam. That's referring to men. And so when you have them break it down, they're trying to say it's referring to mankind. But if the Most High wanted to deal with mankind, he would have dealt with specifics. He would have had Ishar there. Why did he choose that word Adam, meaning the man, representing the man, the same translation for Adam, meaning the man? So we know that's a masculine gender right there. So he's dealing with the man right there. And so Jacob had 13 children. Why did he only name his 12 tribes after his sons? Why? Because the Most High deals with the man, and so did Jacob deal with the men. You understand? So we're not going to, the Christian ideology is confounded. And so when we read again, when we deal with Malachi, we see that the Heavenly Father said, in order to fix the earth, you have to do one thing. When we read the book of Malachi in the Tanakh, he tells us what must be done. And that, he said, behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming and great dreadful day of Adonai. Verse 6, and he shall turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, and the hearts of the children to the fathers, lest I come and I smite the earth with a curse. So now, because they hadn't done that, because now the men want to bring even to everything, the Most High smite the earth. So there's a 400-year period of silence at the Malachi. For 400 years, no prophets, no priests, nobody preaching. And then what happens? HaMashiach Yahusha comes on the scene, and what is he going to get? He's going to get 12 men to help spread this word, the Basura, the good tidings to the earth. First to Yahshua Allah, fulfilling the scriptures again. Now let's deal with the other part of it. Let's deal with the other part of it about the men being virgins, because Jair seemed to believe that it's a physical virgin, but it's not. Now we got to remember in Bereshit, Genesis 1:28, Yahuwah said, be fruitful and multiply. He's not going to break his own order. He's not going to give us an order and then punish us for doing what he says. That's not the kind of power we're dealing with here. So he said, be fruitful and multiply. So he would not tell men to be fruitful and multiply, and then when you do, you can't get into the 144,000. This doesn't mean sexual relations within marriage defiles a man. It doesn't mean that. Men who have sex within marriage is not defiled. So it's not talking about physical sex at all. What would defile him if you're talking physically would be having sex with relatives or having threesomes, as mentioned in the book of Leviticus, the 18th chapter. See, Leviticus 18:24 tells you that there's such a thing as being spiritually defiled when you worship other gods. Ezekiel, Leviticus 18:24. Defile not yourselves in any of these things, for in these the nations are defiled, which I cast out before you. Now, Revelations 14 and 4 is obviously talking about men who has not allowed women to influence them and cause them to worship other gods, as did Solomon. See, Solomon, he was defiled by women. How? Not only by having sex with them, but he allowed them to influence his mind, and he went and worshiped other gods. 1 Kings 11 and 4. For it came to pass that Solomon was old, that when Solomon was old, his wives turned away his heart after other gods. You see that? And his heart was not perfect with Adonai. His Elohim was the heart, as was the heart of David, his father. So Solomon got defiled because he'd allow women to influence his mind to worship other gods. And this is what the Heavenly Father is referring to in the book of Revelations 14 and 4. Adonai is jealous, right? And so men who worship other gods can't be of this fault. 2 Corinthians 11 and 2. For I am a jealous God. For I am jealous for you with a godly jealous. For I have betrothed you to one husband, that I may present you as a chaste virgin to Hamashiach, Yahusha. 2 Corinthians 11 and 2. So Israel, understand this thing. Understand this idea and everyone else. Israel is frequently called the virgin daughter of Zion in the scripture. So the Bible uses this symbolism of fornication to represent following other gods. See, that's being defiled. You understand? Whereas relationships within marriage represents oneness and faithfulness to Yahuwah Elohim. So since Israel went out and worshiped these other gods, just like many of you do now, you're in the Christianity, you're in the Islam, you're in the Buddhism, right? You're in the Krishna. That's that you've defiled. You've been spiritually defiled. Why? Because that's fornication against Yahuwah Elohim, Elohim. You understand? So we find evidence in multiple passages, right? But many people ask counsel, right? Check out Hosea 4 and 12, right? He said, many people ask counsel from their wooden idols, right? You worship wood. You worship the cross, right? You worship the black stone, Islam. And their staff informs them. For the spirit of harlotry, that means fornication, has caused them to stray. And they have played the harlot against Yahuwah. Yahuwah. That's Hosea 4 and 12. We go to Hosea 4 and 6. I have seen a horrible thing in the house of Israel. There's a harlotry of Ephraim. Israel is defiled. How is she defiled? She worshiped other gods. So this is a metaphor. It's metaphoric. It's metaphorical, right? It's a metaphorical scenario. It indicates that these men spoken of in Revelations has always been spiritual virgins, meaning they've always followed Yahusha. As it's stated in Revelations 14 and 4, it says they follow the Lamb wherever he goes. That means being in obedience is indicated by the fact that they follow the Lamb wherever he goes. Hallelujah. Bahashem. So the 144,000 are redeemed from amongst men. See, redemption by faith of Yahusha is the qualification of being 144,000. Let's consider Yirmiyahu 31 and 4. Again, I will build thee. Again means you're doing something that he's done before. So these men are what? Born again. And thou shalt be built, O virgin of Israel. Why is he calling her virgin? He's calling Israel virgin. Why? Because you have to be born again. Thou shalt be adorned with my tablets, and shalt thou go forth in the dances of them that make merry. So these men are born again by the Ruach, by the holy Ruach of Yahusha HaMashiach. Consider Yahawah 9:3 and 3. John 3 and 3. Yahusha answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of Yahuwah. Why does he have to be born again? Because Romans 3:10, all have, as it is written, there's none righteous, no, not one. Romans 3:23, for all have sinned and come short to the glory of Yah. You understand? So you got to be born again, right? So, Yachanan, John 3, verse 4, Nicodemus saith unto him, how can a man be born when he's old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb? Verse 5, HaMashiach Yahusha answered, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of the water, that's the washing of the water of the word. It's not talking about baptism. It's talking about the washing of the water, the word. What word? The entire Bible. Not just the Besorah. The entire Bible. Well, except a man be born of the water, of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom. See, you see what I'm saying? So it's the Spirit. These men are spiritual virgins. You understand? Verse 6. That which is born of flesh is flesh, and that which is born of spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I say unto you, you must be born again. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but canst not tell whence it cometh and whether it goeth. So everyone that is born of the Spirit. So the 144,000 is the first fruit of Yahuwah. But that follow the Lamb wherever he goes. So the 144,000 is the beginning of the great harvest of Israel that come out of the tribulation. Revelations, Apocalypse 7, verse 9 reads as thus, and speak of a great multitude that will be saved out of the tribulation. It says, and after these things, I look and behold a great multitude, which no one could number, of all nations, tribes, people, and tongues, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes, with palm branches in their hands. Hallelujah. So the 144,000 are essentially the first fruit. That's all men that have not been defiled by any kind of different ideology. They're not worshiping any other gods, and they're not influenced by feminism or the influence of women. And so a lot of these rabbis and preachers, they're influenced by women and say, no, we want 50-50, so they don't preach the truth. They heave up to itch and edge, and they preach what the people want to hear, but I'm going to teach the truth. Hallelujah. Now you can like that, understand it, believe it or not. Yirmiyahu 31 and 4. Again, I will build thee, and thou shalt be built, O virgin of Israel. Thou shalt again be adorned with the tribute, and shall go forth in the dances of them that make merry. So this is spiritual. These men are spiritual virgins. Their minds have not been defiled. So it is my prayer that the Bityah can receive this message, and the Akim can receive this message. May the Most High be blessed. May the Most High be with you and guide you and give you understanding. As for now, I'm going to say shalom, shalom, yam tov. I pray that you receive this message from the Spirit of which it was given. Hallelujah.
By women.